Action-packed itineraries and round-the-clock adventures in faraway locations. That's what most expect from a holiday. But what if all you really want is to get away to a nearby place for some really deep and restorative sleep?
So here we are, the latest addition to the camper and cabin collection. This is the follow-up to the extremely popular camper and cabin in Batulaon. This looks even more impressive.
Oh. Camper and Cabin Forest is a collection of natural wood cabins and landscape pathways on a ridge overlooking a forest deep inside Alfonso Cavite. The first one, Pine, with its pine wood interiors and tall glass ceiling, is perfect for couples. Largest fir, a cluster of three villas can accommodate an extended family. Third, Oak, will fit six guests comfortably.
When they officially launch this property, all three cabins will be fully operational. For now, however, only this one is available. It's called Oak. It's got this beautiful, minimalist Japanese aesthetic, which I really love. And yes, like the name of this cabin, the walls are actually made of oak. Beautiful.
It's got all the elements I look for in a restful space, a clean and light-filled environment with views and sounds of nature filling the cabins. Indeed, there's a zen-like feel to the place, no doubt inspired by the clean lines, the uncluttered walls, and the natural surfaces all over the space, especially wood, oak mostly, which brings back memories of the traditional wooden inns of Japan.
I must say, I'm really loving this place. It reminds me so much of those beautiful traditional machiya houses of Kyoto or traditional Japan. It's got this sitting room with tatami mats, with a view of a Japanese rock garden. Of course, the smell of oak and the smell of pine. Smell of natural straw. Ah, this is really lovely.
Japanese touches like the traditional engawa, the wooden veranda, and karasensui, a rock garden, don't feel contrived at all. They bring a calm and meditative mood to the cabin. The use of shoji, movable screens, and fusuma, sliding doors throughout the space, likewise bring the outdoors within.
So views like that and perspectives like this, and like this, it's what makes camper and cabin so beautiful.
It's also serene. I could fall asleep on the floorboards like the Japanese do, but they have separate sleeping quarters too.
So let's check out the bedrooms. This is one of two bedrooms in the cabin. This is where I'm staying. And I just love these traditional Japanese touches. Like a machiya in Kyoto.
Large, comfortable beds with Tempur-branded mattresses, plus a clean and cozy space. I'll have no problem falling asleep here.
Wow, this is really nice. Just look at those touches. The wooden slats, the natural tree, natural stone. I would have wanted a hinoki tub, you know, a Japanese cedar tub, but who's complaining? Just look at that view. And as beautiful as the interiors are, and they're really beautiful, so is this view of the outdoors. It's this view of the forest of Alfonso.
On On a warm and humid day, nothing beats soaking at a pool while staring at the treetops and sky. While, why not? Dozing off, perhaps. The landscape, the architecture, they share many of the same qualities of its sister property, Camper and Cabin in Batulao. And that's because it's designed and built by the same owner.
Hey, Dan, I was just admiring your creation.
Hi,
David. Congratulations. Wow, this is beautiful.
Yeah, welcome here.
Yeah, wow.
Dan shows me around his largest cabin called Fir. Like the oak cabin next door, this was named after a tree whose wood, Douglas fir, was used to build the structures.
Oh, so we name it after that.
So nothing is artificial, no?
Nothing's
like
artificial,
everything
yeah.
is like, if it's stone, it's stone, if it's wood, it's wood.
Yes, exactly. We wanted to merge the structure with the surrounding environment. So we have integrated wood and natural materials, connecting the interiors of the cabins to the dense forest outside.
The dark colored structure using an ancient Japanese technique called Shusugiban employs blackening the wood with fire to preserve and protect it from the elements. Fir is actually three cabins built around pools of water, overlooking the hills of Alfonso. The main cabin comes with a spacious lanai with dining area and an upper floor for the sleeping quarters. All structures stand on stilts to provide better views of the surrounding scenery.
Wow, what is this?
So this is the catwalk.
Catwalk.
Leading to the deck.
The elevated walkway creates a private corner for morning yoga sessions or cocktails at sundown amidst a canopy of trees.
There seems to be a pattern, Batulao, middle of nowhere, yeah. Here, middle of a forest. Mm. Are you looking for something like yeah. that all the time?
Yeah, from mountain and then we move to a forest. Uh-huh. And then later on, maybe, baka sea naman.
For now, however, they're busy finishing the cabins, fine-tuning the service, and perfecting the on-site restaurant.
Unlike the Camper and Cabin in Batulao, which is a bit closer to the restaurants of Tagaytay on the ridge, this property is a bit more isolated, a bit more remote, but that's not a problem because the owners decided to put up an in-house restaurant. They call it Campfire by Bawais, and they serve cuisine that matches the environment.
The Pan-Asian farm-to-fork restaurant is a joint venture with Bawais, a popular Vietnamese destination dining place located in nearby Silang.
Campfire by Bawais is actually created specifically for Camper and Cabin.
What makes it different from the Bawais that most people know about?
This one is a bit more modern. Tapo, and some of the dishes are actually created just for them. Mm. We had to infuse it with the concept, the overall concept of the space.
Which means mostly Southeast Asian dishes and refreshments with natural ingredients and a lot of local fruits and vegetables to match the leafy, Balinese-inspired wood and stone structure of their restaurant. Apart from entertaining walk-in guests who aren't staying in the cabins, Campfire also offers 24/7 room service to those who are.
The staff actually stays here so that they could cater to the guests anytime. Like for example, in the middle of the night, I'm craving for something. So you can just call
in. Noodles at night.
Yes.
You can get pho in the room.
Yes.
That night.
Mm. Here case, it's like a full restaurant.
It's like a full restaurant. Mm-hmm. You're coming all the way here and you can expect the service, the food, the variety, and quality of a good restaurant, full restaurant. No need to drive anywhere.
Because if you're staying, you just rest, relax.
Exactly.
Time saved by doing away with driving off to find a place to eat or prepare your own meals in the cabin. It's time gained for, well, more rest and more sleep. Especially when the weather puts you in the mood for it.
Ah, thank you. Mm. The smell of coffee and the smell of rain. In most vacations, being caught in a rainstorm like this one is enough to wreck your entire holiday. But not when you're in the middle of a forest like this one, a tropical forest. The rain is just part of the experience.
Indeed, it's such a lovely space. Your time listening to and sheltering from the rain is never a waste. It's also the perfect soundtrack for a massage with an in-house therapist before an afternoon nap. Once refreshed, there's more lounging to be done again before hitting the sack at night.
Wow, this is a very special and exclusive spot, and only guests of the cabin have access to it. This is where the sun rises, but even during sunset, the view is just amazing. It's a perfect place to enjoy cocktails.
On cue, the staff will arrive with your choice of wine and charcuterie during cocktail hour. And can even set up a campfire for you to grill some steaks and seafood for dinner. And that's what I love about Camper and Cabin Forest. It combines the fun and adventure of an outdoor campsite with the creature comforts of a luxury cabin.